Hello everyone, my name is Mehak. I hope you guys are doing fine and safe. And like always, I also hope that you guys are reading back with another book. So as you all know, this is the month of December and I usually read Christmassy and festive reads. The second book that I finished reading, which was quite delightful and festive, it's This Time Next Year. It's by Sophie Cousins. That's how it looks. It's a paperback. And if I had to suggest one book, only one book that you guys would, if you guys could read this entire month, it would be this book. I think it has all the elements to put you in that festive and nice, feel good, feeling. And it's a light read and it's a rom-com. So you will have a gala time reading this. Now, coming to the story, it's about Quinn and Minnie. These are our two characters. So Minnie and Quinn are basically two people who are born at the same time, almost like a difference of 1 minute, at the same hospital in the year 1990. But Quinn not only, edged Minnie by being born 1 minute earlier to her and winning the cash prize of being the first baby born in London on the New Year's Eve, but he also stole her name. So you must be wondering, what is this? So I'll give you a little background. So their mother, like Tara and Connie, were basically birthing roommates, and Tara was having a lot of difficulty delivering her child. And in order to distract her, Connie basically helps her and she starts talking and helps her out. And that's when, just to distract her, she says that, I have decided to name my baby girl as Quinn, because the name Quinn is apparently considered lucky and it brings good luck. But the next thing she knows, that not only Tara delivers her baby 1 minute earlier, so obviously she wins the cash prize because her baby is born first in London on the New Year's Eve, but Tara also names her boy as Quinn, because she heard that it brings good luck, and she names her child as Quinn. So obviously Connie is upset about it, and her daughter is left with the name Minnie Cooper. Minnie Cooper, yes, because their second name is Cooper. So obviously Minnie has been at the suffering end of a lot of Minnie Cooper jokes throughout her life. And in fact, since the time she was born, because her name was stolen and they couldn't, win the cash prize as well, Minnie's mom believes that she's an unlucky child, and as Minnie grows, she herself believes that she's jinxed and she's unlucky, and that's the reason she literally spends all her New Year's Eve birthday, locked in home. Because, and she has all reasons too, because in the book there has been a lot of instances wherein all her birthdays, New Year birthdays, have been disastrous. So in order to avoid the jinx and the wrong happenings, she literally stays locked in her house. But until 30 years later now, she's dating this guy, and she decides, why not I just go out and celebrate in order to make him feel book. But knowing her luck, she again spends her New Year's Eve the entire night locked in the bathroom. And next morning, the guy to rescue her and save her is none other than Quinn Hamilton, the guy 30 years back, before, who was born with her in the same hospital and who stole her name. So he's this, and so now 30 years later, he's there right at the same hotel and he has rescued Minnie. And Minnie looks at him, and she all through her life, she has literally hated him, because she feels that he took her luck and the cash prize and the name and everything. So she literally resents him, and when she sees him, she wants to hate him all the more, because when she sees him, she realizes that he's clearly got the good luck, because he's charming, handsome, and he's a successful businessman, while Minnie is a struggling business owner and she's really trying to make sense of herself and her professional career. But the moment she looks into his gorgeous eyes, she realizes that it's going to be really difficult, hating him, because he's obviously gorgeous and handsome and he's sweet and kind as well. And now, the next thing you know is that they both keep bumping into each other, and all the interactions are filled with frustration. But in spite of all that, there's this beautiful friendship that keeps blooming and starts developing between both of them, where both of them starts expecting something more and hoping more. But the fact is also that both of them are currently dating someone else. So while, you know, in the present this is happening, that Quinn and Minnie keep meeting each other and bumping into each other, the book jumps between back and forth, and it also, you know, takes us through in the past New Year's Eve, throughout many years, wherein, you know, the author tells us that Quinn and Minnie have been, you know, around each other at the same time, at the same location, you know, around the New Year's Eve, but they just didn't bump into each other, but they have been literally been present in each other's orbit. So more like, you know, star-crossed lovers, I would say, who keep meeting, but keep getting separated for various reasons. And then it takes, finally takes them 30 years to find each other. Sounds like a perfect plot, but it's not a smooth ride for them, because even in the present, when they keep meeting, they keep separating for various reasons. And the ending is absolutely beautiful. You have to read that for yourself to find out what ending Quinn and Minnie gets for themselves. The ending is sweet, funny, and adorable and beautiful. I remember, you know, as soon as I finished the book, I put it on my Insta story and I tagged the author, that saying, you know, and she replied, the author was so sweet, that the ending is so beautiful, you know, it makes you so happy. The characters are extremely likable, you know, you'll fall in love with Quinn, Minnie, and Minnie has this really nice best friend, you would, Lila. She's beautiful, so you would, you know, reading that, you would wish that you also had a best friend like that, who will stick by you through all thick and thin. And yeah, so it's, this book has clearly become my one of my favorite rom-coms. And like I said, if there's one book that I would suggest that you should definitely read this month, it would be this one. A lot of adorable moments in this book. And you know, it leaves us with a parting message, you know, that I really liked in this book, that fate and destiny, you know, whatever you want to call it, it has a beautiful way, or a magical way, to bring two people together, you know, unexpected, and in spite of all the odds. So if you're meant to be, the destiny gets two people together, even when you don't expect it, and even if you have, you know, so many odds and hurdles and problems, but it definitely has a way of bringing two people together. So I think that is the beautiful parting message of this book. Definitely recommend it. So yeah, that's all on this beautiful book. I'm gonna see you next week with another Christmassy, festive, feel good read. Till then, take care, bye bye.